Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Beverly and you're in my kitchen today. I just wanted to take a few minutes this morning and show you some of the things that I do when I'm prepping for meals for the week. And maybe there are some ideas here that may help someone out there watching. So if you're interested to hang out with me for a little bit this morning, please keep watching. Thank you. You okay? You want to go out? So what I'm doing right now is I'm doing meal prep, okay? And I am incorporating this year more vegetables than I typically would, at least in our household. And I'm reducing down the amount of meat. So as you were watching me cut up the other bag of vegetables, so I have one, about one small onion, and I have one whole green pepper, one whole red pepper, and then 6 ounces of the beef kielbasa. And this actually will feed, it could feed 3 people or more if you put rice with it. If you don't eat rice with it, it's going to feed less. But this is how I'm prepping meals. So during the week when it's really busy, all I have to do is take out the bag right here, put a little olive oil in a pan, and saute everything up. If I want to make rice, then I would make rice and have that on the side. And if I get 2 meals out of this, because this is 12 ounces, this whole pack is 12, I'm using only half, which is 6 ounces. And, you know, 3 ounces of meat is usually a serving per person. So this is about 2 meals, but with all the vegetables and everything, it can go actually a lot further. So, these will just go in the refrigerator. I'm not actually freezing these. So most likely my plan this week will be to have one with rice and one without rice. I just tossed this in the bag, and there is no rhyme nor reason. Nothing has to be in any certain order. And as far as the kielbasa, I just use my awesome Dexter knife, this big knife, and I just slice right down the center. And then I cut it in smaller pieces. You could even cut these lengthwise one more time. You see how big the pieces are. You could cut it one more time down each side and have even smaller pieces if your family chose to do that. We like them a certain size, so I'm just cutting them in this way. It's quicker, and we like this size for our meal. And I just take those and stuff them right in the bag. I've been trying to take 1 to 3 types of meat in a week and buy whatever. Usually if you buy in bulk, it will allow you to have more or better price, I should say, a lower price per pound, and have that all laid out and divided for the week. And then if I have to buy in a bigger bulk package, for example, I can take that and cut it out into meals that will last over the course of a month or more. In this case, these are 2 meals. I'm pretty sure we're going to eat these in this week, both meals, one with rice, one without. If for some reason I'm getting towards the end of the week and I realize I'm not going to be using this in this week's meals for whatever reason, I'm going to take this and put it into another Ziploc and freeze it, and it'll be good until I'm ready. So I just set those to the side. This week, the other thing I'm going to be having is the reversed egg roll. I'm not sure if you've ever heard of that before, but actually it's really good. It's just like eating an egg roll, but you are eating it inside out without any kind of bread. No wonton wrapper or an egg wrapper, egg roll wrapper, nothing like that. And you just basically put onions, garlic, ground beef or chicken, whichever one that your family likes. In our case, we're going to be using ground beef. Have you ever heard of a ground beef egg roll? Me either, but we call it reversed egg roll. And I use aminos instead of soy sauce. I'm going to show you what that looks like. It's called liquid aminos, and I use this in the place of soy sauce whenever I go to make the meal. So what I would do is I would cut up the cabbage, which I'll probably make 2 meals out of this also. Cabbage, you think that, oh my gosh, that's so much because it's so dense, and it is, but it makes, it reduces down in size, and because of that, you can use a lot of it in your dishes. So this would be 2 meals for us, and I will do it exactly like I do the other packs, where I put everything in a Ziploc except for the meat. I'm not going to put the meat in a Ziploc because what I do is I brown the hamburger meat, brown the ground beef. That's a tongue twister. And once I brown it, then with the onion, then I put in the liquid aminos and the cabbage. And I let it basically cook down until the cabbage is tender, because of course I would have cooked the meat before I put the cabbage in. And I have tried this with chicken You can really put any meat in that you want. It doesn't have to be what I do, but you could put anything in there. It could be chicken, pork. You know, people eat different types of egg rolls, and that is fine. As you can see, I don't actually cut the cabbage in too small of chunks because we're going to be eating that with a fork or a spoon. So I don't want shreds. Some people may use shreds, but I don't. And you can see already how much just one half of that is creating for the cut up cabbage. And that is absolutely okay. And again, I'm going to do this two times for each half, and this will be two meals. And depending on how hungry we are, if we had this for dinner, this is something that could potentially be a leftover for lunch the next day. But I find that we really don't have much left over. Okay, so that's the first bag of cabbage. This is a gallon Ziploc bag, and you can see it's almost full. Let me step back. You can see it's almost full, like more than halfway full. So here we'll just do the same thing. I take the core out. I don't like this piece in my food, so I always take that out. And I also don't have, I'm moving you around here. I also don't have a specific way that I cut this every single time. Sometimes I'll slice it in two. Sometimes I'll slice it like this and then slice it again from here. I mean, it just depends. The bottom line is just to get it sliced into manageable pieces that you can throw into your pan. I do use a little bit of oil, and it is the sesame oil, and I will show you that as well. The kind that I'm using right now is this. I got this at my local Jungle Gyms. It's a national specialty store for different regions, but you can use any sesame oil. It doesn't have to be that brand, but I put it in here because it gives it a really nice Asian flavor. So between the two, the aminos. And you're going to say, how much aminos do you put? Not very much, because it's very salty. You would use it just like you would if you were using soy sauce. So, not that much. Maybe a tablespoon and a half, something like that. And then the sesame oil, I just drizzle it over. I use the leanest ground beef that I can afford when I make this, because I don't like the leaner cuts, or the fattier cuts of beef. I like the leaner cuts. So I usually try to get 80 something or higher. It would have to be nothing else left before I would go with anything below 80. And I have done that in the past, but there's no meat left. It's all grease. It's all fat, you know. Which makes sense, because that's what you're paying for. Some people think it tastes better, but I don't like to have to drain all that off. It just to me it feels like a lot of extra work. So, and it's not as maybe healthier for you to eat the fat. So I don't do it if I can help it. Now what this does, if I prep all of my ingredients, I was going to say products, if I prep all of my ingredients before the start of the new week, then what happens is if I have a stressful day or I have a lot going on for that week, I don't really have to think too much about what it is that I'm going to make for dinner. And like I said, a lot of these dinners may carry over into lunch for the next day. But for the most part, my dinners would be taken care of. So right now, out of the two of these things that I've prepped, I have two inside out, except for I need to put the onions in these, which I'm going to do next. But I have two of the inside out egg rolls. That'd be two meals. And then I have the kielbasa meals with all of the fresh vegetables, and one's going to be with rice and one will be without rice. So there's four meals right there. So what I typically do is I see how many vegetables I have left from the week before. I think most people do this before they go grocery shopping. They kind of see, what do I have left in my house? That's what I do. I kind of see like what's left over, how many onions do I have, how many this and that. And then I try to plan my meals around the vegetables that I have left. And then think about what meals I want to add in. So if sometimes, like if you buy a 10-pound bag of potatoes, for example, then you know that that week, you're probably not going to eat 10 pounds of potatoes in 1 week, right? So you would have potatoes left for the following week and so on. So I look at every vegetable I have. If anything new comes into the house, I determine if I'm going to be cutting it up and freezing it, or if I'm actually going to be using it for meals. And I like fresh vegetables, so the chances of me actually using it that week when I'm doing my meal prep is going to be high. Sometimes I do have to freeze things, and I think that's common with everyone. But I think fresh is better. So here I'm just going to take the onion and put it right on top. When it all gets in there, you can't even tell there's onion in it. But there is. You can also take shredded carrot and put it in here as well, if that's something that you have. And I don't have shredded carrots, but I'm going to be using my carrots for something else today. So I'm not going to be putting carrots in with my reversed egg roll this time. But in the future I might. The only other thing that I may add in here at the time of cooking would be garlic. I love garlic, so I'd probably put garlic in there. And you may just want some heat. In that case, you could put some peppers or something in there. So now I just kind of lay this out flat after I get it all sealed. And now I have two of these meals ready to go as soon as I make up the ground beef portions. And that I'm going to be doing next. Okay, I know that meat is controversial, so I will say now I'm getting ready to portion out ground beef. So if that's something that you're sensitive to, you might want to go ahead and fast forward through this part. And I respect your decisions for what you eat in your family, and I would hope that you could also respect mine. So I just wanted to give that warning. So I'm getting ready to cut the meat now. So for those of you that stuck around, the place where I went to shop today was Walmart, and I found that the tube of meat, which I think is also controversial, that's what I purchased. That's what I could afford this week, and that is what I bought. This is the 80 lean and 20 fat. This is from my local Walmart. So what I do, before I go shopping, the other thing that I do is I make sure that I have the items that I'm going to need for wrapping everything in. And I was low on aluminum foil, which is what I wrap the ground beef in typically. So I decided to pick up another one today, which I did. And I picked up the 225 square feet versus the 150 square feet of the heavy duty that I'm going to be using today. But anyway, that is not the reason that, or not the reason why we're here today. But I did want to mention that. So in my meal prep is also prepping to make sure that I have the items that I need in order to be able to store the food that I buy. So here I'm just taking a knife, and again, I do all my vegetables first. That way that's all done. And then I get out this plastic cutting board. I just place it on top of the wood. It gives it more stability. And then I just cut down the center of this tube to open it. And then of course, after I'm done with all of this, what I will do is I will add a little bit of bleach to my dishwater and make sure that these things are washed fairly good. Okay. So this is, I didn't mention this, but this is the 5 pounds. So we can actually get 10 meals out of the 5 pounds of meat. We don't actually eat a lot of beef. I think I'm probably the one that eats it most in the house. But because of that, I just cut every single time that we make any dish that has beef in it. It's really half of a pound. So we would definitely get about half of the pound that people typically might use in their, you know, recipes and whatnot. So what I do is I'm cutting this straight down the center. And also, I'll show you on the pack. The pack actually has a measurement that you could use if you wanted to. I just gauge it. I don't actually use that, but I will show it to you before we go today. So I just take my, there's a seam. You can see a seam when you go into the roll. And I just put my finger straight down to the bottom of that seam and make sure that it's halved all the way through. And then I'm just going to go down and do it 5 times. You know, slit it like, or slice it rather, 5 times. Now, some of the ends is not exactly right, and I will just go ahead and figure that out. So on the side, I take my foil. I'm going to need 10 pieces. Takes me almost to the end of my roll, you can see. So I just take off 10 pieces of foil and I set that to the side over here. And then I have my gloves. I keep putting these, taking these on and off. But I just kind of go down on that half a pound and I put it over into the foil. And then I fold it over and you'll see what I do with it next. I just kind of make like a neat little package. Let me see if I can slide this over so you can see what I do with it. I just fold it over once and flatten it out as much as I can. And then I do the same thing on the other side. Fold in the inside or each side. And now I have this little patty. And then I start making those and then stacking them up. And I'm just going to, this is what I'm going to be stacking up, but it's going to be off camera. But you know what I'm going to be doing. But I just keep doing that until I get all of the meat into these little patties. I say patties, but portions, if you will. And they're about a half a pound each. Until I get to the end, and I think there's just a little more than these. But that's okay, because we don't eat a lot of meat when we're doing ground beef. It does last us a while. So I'm going to fast forward through this part, but that is what I'm doing here. So you get an idea about how I package the meat that I take out of this tube. Okay, now the meat is done, so let me show you on the outside of this package where it actually shows you where the pounds are. It's sometimes missed because it's in this crease, but I think they have this. This looks like maybe it's in fourth pounds. Do you see these little lines right here all across your pack? That is the cut lines, so they try to help you out. And I want to say that's probably a fourth. I thought it was, yeah, that's true. It says cut at seam markings for approximately 1/4 pound. So sometimes this little crease, when they package it, it covers that and no one even sees these little marks. But that is where you're supposed to cut the meat. So that's another tip for you. All right, well, let me just clean up here and then I'm gonna come back and show you my little packets and then I'm gonna put that in the freezer. Okay, so here are my little packets. It basically looks like a hamburger patty, but I'm calling them packets. And I will put these in the refrigerator. Actually, I'll put these in the freezer. I'm putting all of these in the freezer. These 8. And I have 8 meals that I can make with these. So, you know, if I know one day in a couple of weeks or a week from now that I'm going to be making tacos, for example, I'll take one of these out to use in a taco recipe or whatever I'm doing for that meal. And then they'll be done. Now, I have also done the thing where you take all of your meat, all 5 pounds of it or however much you buy, and you saute it up and put the onions in, and then you freeze it that way, and then you can freeze it like crumbles, and then you can take it out for anything that you want to make. But this time I'm not doing that. I'm going to leave it just like this because that's just how we're going to do it this time. These other two packs are a little more, I want to say, than the half pound. And these are the two that I'm going to be using in the reversed egg roll recipe later in the week. So I'm just going to keep those out in the crisper or closer to the back of the refrigerator where it's really cold. I'm not going to freeze these though. I did notice that the roll, it felt almost like it had been frozen or partially frozen. So when you go to the store and you pick up your meat at Walmart, you might want to check that. I know sometimes when, or at least this is what I found. I don't know that this is a fact by any means, but with the way that the meat situation is going, there seems to be times when I've gone in and even chicken is frozen in the, not in the frozen section, if that makes sense. So it's in the area where you would expect it to be thawed out, but it is frozen, like it's defrosting, you know, or thawing out. So just keep an eye on that. Be mindful that sometimes it's not a good idea to refreeze meat. You can look all that up. That's not what this video is about, but just saying, just put it out there. Take a look at it when you buy it to see what you're getting. Okay, that is everything in this video that I wanted to share for today. I hope this finds you and your families well in this time in the world right now. And until my next video, take care.